I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Earlier, when you decided to withhold information from Natalie about her medical scans, that was to avoid court. Stress.
Right.
What if you were unable to make that choice? If you had no choice?
Odin?
I would like to take this opportunity to remind you that Standard Venturis Corporation safety protocol requires all crew to enter cryogenic sleep immediately upon the loss of primary oxygen supply.
What?
As Tacoma Station's medical officer, it is within your power to order all crew to enter cryogenic sleep.
Odin, Nat and Bert are right in the middle of... Oh no.
Sarah, there is a fire suppression device.
Are you okay? Can you feel your feet and hands?
Ew! Ow! My hip just hurts!
Work.
What will you do now?
Then tell me what
you are going to do.
I'm going to give them a little time to get over the shock, but then we're going into cryo.
Sarah, please listen carefully. I am not telling you what to do, but I am mentioning that there is a door in the network technology module that is normally inaccessible to the crew, and it is true that you could, before proceeding to cryo, investigate that door.
What are you telling me here, Odin?
I have told you all that I can. Simple facts. Nothing more.
Oh my god, Odin. Are my patients stable?
Yes.
Their conditions won't degrade if I leave them here?
They should not.
Is there some door in networking that we can't normally get into?
Yeah, it's Odin's hardware compartment, but we're not allowed direct access. Why?
Where is it?
What have you got on your mind, Doc?
Please, I'm sorry. That fire just burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's here. In networking. You'll have to go through the maintenance shaft to get there. Here's the technical access code.
Okay. You don't let her go to sleep. And you don't let her move.
Sarah, what's going on?
I wish I knew. I'm gonna go find out.
Hey there, I'm Nat. Pleased to meet you.
Hello, I am Odin. I look forward to working together.
Same here, mate.
Odin, is this it?
That is the location I mentioned.
You're there? You're gonna need a crowbar or something.
No, it's open. It's just hanging open.
What?
I must inform you that Venturis regulations forbid contracting crew members direct access to AI hardware. But I cannot prevent you from proceeding.
Matt, I'm going in.
Okay, just be careful.
Is this... What is all this? Communication records?
I cannot prevent you from accessing exposed data in this restricted area.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, he's recording. It is with great sadness that I address you today, February 29th, 2088. Mere hours ago, six loyal men and women, the crew of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma, lost their lives serving Venturis, and all of us who rely on the orbital economy. Tragically, due to human error on the part of the crew, Venturis rescue technicians were not made aware of the catastrophic oxygen loss until it was too late. Our heartfelt thoughts and prayers are with their families. If only tragedies like this were avoidable. But in truth, they are. As we know, each minute that human workers spend stationed, isolated in orbit is another opportunity for heroes, like the crew of Tacoma, to lose their lives. We at Venturis say no more. The partisan obstructionism that led to the failure of the Orbital Worker Safety Bill has claimed its last victim. Today, We hereby renew our solemn pledge to fight for the legalization of fully automated orbital facilities. We encourage, we humbly beg everyone listening to this message to contact their OSEP representative and voice their support in honor of the crew of Tacoma. There never need be another tragedy like this one. And now, a moment of silence in their memory.
Okay, and then we just cut it there, silent for a minute, and then what? Amazing Grace? No, I don't need another take. That was fine.
If someone were to override that protocol, external communications channels would be restored.
Odin, thank you. Hailing any ship within radio range of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma. This is an SOS. Is anybody out there?
Thank you.
He's still waking up. Just keep him talking.
So the drone worked?
No, the drone didn't work.
What's going on then?
We're going to Jupiter, Andrew. Isn't that exciting?
I've never been.
Nat, give him a break.
We're not going to be home for a while. Right, you're not going to miss your kid's graduation or anything, are you?
Oh, Nicholas, no, no. Yeah, you know Nicholas, why, he would never do something like that.
She said they'd be kind of out of it for a while.
Andrew, what's important is we're getting out of this alive. We're gonna be somewhere where VT can't touch us for a while.
Probably have to replace the station AI entirely while he regrows.
Odin, I'm not gonna let that happen, okay? Don't worry.
I'm back.
Okay. Ship is ready to depart. Please strap into the pilot seat.